Hello and welcome. You're watching Property Hotline with me, Kavita Krishnan. And today we are going to help you with answers to all your legal queries on buying, selling and investing in real estate. To answer your questions, I have with me Aditya Pratap, advocate of Aditya Pratap and Associates. Aditya, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Let's take Shreyas's question first. Now, he asks us if there is any move to prevent the resale of property at a higher value than what is registered to New Future. He wants to know, can such resale at a higher or a lower price be prevented? He says that the seller may not show the actual higher price in a sale deed, but may unofficially take the difference between the actual higher price and the price declared in the deed. Aditya?
Certainly. This is a very common question. And many a time, you know, people have this dilemma that if the property is high, just sell at the ready reckoner. Should we sell above or below the ready reckoner and so on? The answer is very simple. Under the Bombay Stamp Act of 1958, Section 2NA states that the market value of a property for the purposes of determining the stamp duty is the market value, that is, the price which the property will fetch in the open market or the ready reckoner value, whichever is higher. So if the ready reckoner value is higher than the actual market value, then the stamp duty will be payable on the ready reckoner value. But if the open market price is higher, then the parties cannot take the lower ready reckoner price as an excuse to undervalue the property and avoid stamp duty. So yes, the stamp duty will be payable on that property, on that value which is higher, be it the ready reckoner or the market value. Now let's suppose a transaction happens. The ready reckoner value of a property is 4 crores. The parties sell it for 3.5 crores. What are the implications? As I said, that the stamp duty will be payable on the amount of 4 crores. Secondly, under the Income Tax Act, we have sections 50 and 56 by which the difference in the income will be deemed to be the income of the parties. So in case a property of 4 crores, ready reckoner, is sold for 3.5 crores, then the extra 50 lakhs, if the seller has made 3.5 crores, then the extra 50 lakhs will be added to the income of the seller for the purpose of computing his capital gains tax. Further, in case the property for the buyer, the balance 50, which he underpaid, that balance 50 may be added to his income from other sources. So we also have an instance of double taxation which will be made out. And finally, these days, given the drive against black money, there are numerous amendments which have come in 2013, 2016, which may state that income, that this difference between the low market value and the high ready reckoner value may also be regarded as concealed income. So yes, not only will there be certain stamp duty implications, there will also be taxation implications. Hence, my advice to parties will be, you will anyways have to pay the ready reckoner of the higher value, be it ready reckoner or the market value, but you must at least sell at the ready reckoner or at the market value.
So sell the ready reckoner. Ideally, you need to pay tax on the higher value. That is what you need to remember as both buyer and seller. But my question here to you, Aditya, is essentially this. There are a lot of markets, property markets around the country.
Yes.
Some of them being Calcutta, Delhi. And these are cities where a large amount of property transactions do happen. And here what we've seen is that ready reckoner rates have kept going up. But the market, the actual market rate of the properties have stayed flat. They have not really grown. And that has been a bone of contention for a long time between, you know, people who are looking to sell property.
Yes.
And the tax man. But in cases like this, when there is a huge difference, and you gave an example of a 50 lakh rupee differentiator, there are cases where the difference is much, much more. In such a case, does the person who's paying the tax, does the taxpayer here have any redressal whatsoever? Can they go to court?
No. As far as the stamp duty is concerned, it is the law. So if it is not the market value, it is a ready reckoner. The simple reason for this is that the state has a minimum expectation of revenue. So the law assumes that the state government will apply its mind and set the ready reckoner rates accordingly. But once the ready reckoner rates are set, the transaction amount may be anything, it may be below. But then if the transaction amount is below, the ready reckoner valuation will be taken into account for the purposes of computing the stamp duty. And further, as far as the difference is concerned, well, then as far as the income tax officer is concerned, he may have to be convinced. He may like take a look at the average price of the transactions in the area, the average asking price of builders in the area. He may have a discretion. So as far as income tax is concerned, yes, the buyer may get a reprieve, but stamp duty will be payable on the ready reckoner value.
Going by what you're saying, it looks like it makes much more sense to just sit and hold on tight to that property and actually wait for either your property prices to go up or the ready reckoner rates to be revised downwards, because this sounds like a whole lot of problems that you're actually inviting for yourself. A, you pay a higher stamp duty, and B, you also have to convince the tax department that your deal was in fact perfectly legal.
To an extent, yes. But my advice would be that usually the stamp duty is what? It's like 5% or something of the property value. Hmm. So the marginal difference will not be much. So what I would advise is for the serious property buyer who's looking at has a long-term view, he might as well go ahead with this transaction. He may, depending on the bargaining power of him and the builder, he may also negotiate with the builder, okay, I'm paying so much, so you give me some additional incentives. But as a lawyer, as a lawman, I would just quote the provisions of the Stamp Act, because law is law. We have to ask the parliament to change it or we follow it.
Law is law, and this time it's clearly not on the side of either the home buyer or the one who's selling that property. But moving on to Mihir's question, he says he's purchased a flat in Noida, Sector 78. Now, the builder is given one free covered parking along with the flat. Now, total cost of the flat, as stated in the allotment letter, is 66 lakh rupees, inclusive of this one free covered parking, which costs 4 lakh rupees. Now, Mihir wants to know whether he has to pay the stamp duty on 66 lakh or on 66 plus 4, that is 70 lakh rupees.
Yes.
The builder has given Mihir an offer of possession stating that he has to register his free covered parking at a cost of 4 lakh rupees along with the flat.
Well, the answer is in black and white. The builder is trying to mislead the buyer. For the simple reason that the Supreme Court of India, in the case of Nahal Chand Lalu Chand versus Panchali Cooperative Housing Society, has clearly held that the parking space cannot be reckoned to be a separate flat and sold, Parking spaces are a part of the common areas of the society and they cannot be subdivided, separately registered or sold. Further, we have the Noida Building Regulations of 2010. Table 5 of the Noida Building Regulations state that parking areas, whether in basement, ground or podium, are excluded from the floor area ratio computation. They are excluded from the computation of saleable area, and therefore, when we read this in conjunction with the Supreme Court ruling, the parking, it is nothing but a part of the common areas. Further, as per the Supreme Court ruling and the law, the builder can levy the construction cost of the charges for the common areas by proportionately dividing it among all the flats in accordance with the carpet area. So if a person has a carpet area of 500 square feet, the proportionate common area charges will be less compared to a person who has a flat of, say, 2,000 square feet. He cannot, say, put 4 lakh rupees for each flat and, give a parking. Secondly, let's suppose you decide not to pay these 4 lakhs. Then the builder cannot withhold your parking, because under the Noida Building Regulations, at least one parking per flat, and assuming your flat, if your flat is 800 square feet, you get one parking. If it's 1,600 square feet, you get two parkings. You have every legal right to insist upon these car parkings. Thirdly, since these are part of the common areas, it is legally impermissible for a builder to carve out a covered parking space separately and get it registered separately as a different item of property. Such an act would amount to contempt and a complete violation of the Supreme Court judgment in the case of Nahal Chand Lalu Chand. The law has been laid down, and developers cannot change this reality.
Right. But then what does he do? Because obviously he's already bought the flat here and he's also paid that 4 lakh rupees extra for parking.
Yes.
So what do you suggest he does now? So when he goes to register, he only registers the flat, or does he not register the deal at all? What does he have to do over here?
Now, first of all, he may register the flat because on paper, prima facie, a car park cannot be registered separately.
Right.
Only that item can be registered, which is a flat. And a flat is a distinct accommodation unit. A car parking is not a flat. So if the sub-registrar himself is an intelligent person, he can raise a question that how can I register a parking separately? Because a parking is part of the common areas and the common areas of a building are conveyed to the society. Tomorrow the society may raise an objection that the car parks are a part of the common areas. How can you register separately the name of one person? Let the society allot the car parks. But registry legally is not permissible. And he can also raise an objection to this effect before the sub-registrar. He can call for proceedings under, I think, sections 31, 32 of the Registration Act. There are certain sections which allow the registrar to conduct an inquiry. And thirdly, if he has paid, he can give a letter saying that I have paid under protest. And immediately, he can commence proceedings under the Consumer Protection Act.
Who does he give this letter to?
To the builder.
To the builder.
He can tell the builder that you had taken payment 4 lakh rupees for me for this parking. Such a payment violates the Supreme Court judgment. You are accordingly called upon to reimburse my payment, failing which I'll commence legal action.
So here's what you need to do. What you need to understand is you're not supposed to be buying or selling parking in the first place. Now that this parking has been sold to you already, you've already paid 4 lakh rupees, you can write a letter to the builder and ensure that you have a copy with yourself where the builder has acknowledged receipt of that letter. Ideally, what you need to do is send it by registered post. And once you do that, you can also go and register this sale, agreement, but only register the agreement for the flat. And you can also bring it to the notice of the sub-registrar, like Aditya told you. And what does he do? Go to the consumer forum, Aditya?
Now, well, it is certainly the consumer forum. And in case the building is under construction, he can move the RERA. But assuming that the building is complete and let's suppose the OC has been granted before the RERA Act came into force, the consumer forum is an apt remedy. And in addition, he can also file a civil suit. So the law is on his side and he can easily, the best forum for him would be the consumer forum from what I see it.
Right. I know that we have Mr. R.K. Singh who's on the line from Navi Mumbai. But before we go across to him, one quick question to you. And the fact is that developers openly sell parking.
Yes.
And that is something that is known and everybody knows it. And in most cases, what you're given is a blanket price which includes the cost of parking and you're asked to buy it. Now, in such a case where everybody is openly selling, buying and selling parking despite a Supreme Court order to the contrary, what can be done?
Well, first of all,
because then you run the risk of not having parking.
Exactly. I'll answer this in two parts. Number one, if the building has... Okay, the builder may state that total consideration amount is X, you are being given a flat and one parking. Fair enough. But let's suppose he charges separately for the parking, then the buyer can record a protest to this effect and issue the builder legal notice and commence legal proceedings to recover that amount which the builder claims to have charged for the parking. Secondly, the builder cannot carve out the parking space separately and register it in the name of the because to register the parking in the name of the builder or of the buyer would amount to selling that parking space, deducting it from the common area of the society, which is not permissible. Thirdly, if the flat buyer thinks, I will not get parking if I don't pay, that is wrong. The day he finds that his building is that he's not getting parking in his own complex, he can easily file a complaint with the Noida authority or the concerned municipality saying that please review the builder's building plans. It is my legal right. And please initiate proceedings against the developer for misrepresenting his plans. Because on paper, the builder has to show the prescribed number of car parkings, which are proportionate to the number and size of the flats.
So there you have it. You need not buy parking. You have a legal right to get parking with a flat that you are buying from the developer. If he insists on you buying the parking, then you can do so. And you can actually send a letter to the developer saying that you're doing this under duress. Essentially, you are under protest. I'm sorry. You need to say that you are not agreeing to this, but you are doing so under protest and do maintain a copy of that letter. You can also take that particular developer to court. And also, very important thing that you need to remember, you cannot sell this parking when you sell your flat. It goes back to the housing society. So it's actually a loss-making deal. We have Mr. R.K. Singh on the line now from Navi Mumbai. Mr. Singh, go on. What's your question?
Yes, sir. Madam, can I speak in Hindi?
हाँ जी बोलिए सर क्या सवाल है आपका?
हाँ मैडम मैंने एक सेल एग्रीमेंट किया है मेरे फ्लैट का और वो सेल एग्रीमेंट करने से पहले मैंने सोसाइटी से वो इंटरव्यू किया था और लेकिन सोसाइटी का एनओसी मैंने नहीं लिया, लेकिन तो इंटीमेट किया था मैंने बाद में, मैंने जब सेल एग्रीमेंट करने के बाद जब एनओसी के लिए गया तो उन्होंने जितने भी चार्जेस बताए मैंने सब चार्जेस भर दिए, एनओसी के भी चार्जेस भर दिए और मेरे सब चेक क्लियर हो गए। बाद में वो बोलते हैं कि आपने सेल एग्रीमेंट जो होता है फर्स्ट बात वो आप पहले क्यों कर लिया, आपको मैं एनओसी नहीं दूंगा। अभी मेरा सेल डीड होना बाकी है, अभी लोन होना बाकी है, सिक्योर ट्रांसफर होना बाकी है, तो वो बोलते हैं कि फर्स्ट पार्ट भी आपको विदाउट एनओसी नहीं कर सकते हैं।
मिस्टर सिंह ये बताइए कि आपने जब इंटीमेशन सोसाइटी को इंटीमेट किया था, क्या आपने लेटर भेजा था उन्हें?
हाँ मैडम, ने मैंने उनको बोला था कि मैं अपना ये फ्लैट इस आदमी को बेचने जा रहा हूँ, मेरा कितना ड्यूज हो बता दीजिए, और फिर मैं अपना एग्रीमेंट 5 तारीख को किया, उन्होंने 12 तारीख को एक मीटिंग बुलाई और फिर मैंने बताया कि मैंने तो सेल एग्रीमेंट किया हुआ है, और फिर उन्होंने जितनी भी ड्यूज बताया मैंने किया, उन्होंने चेक भी लिया और क्लियर किया उन्होंने। बाद में उन्होंने लेटर दिया कि नहीं आपका ड्यूज सब क्लियर है बट आपने एक सेल एग्रीमेंट पहले क्यों किया, तो हम आपको एनओसी नहीं देंगे।
मैं आदित्य को पूछ रही हूँ कि आदित्य इस मामले में क्या कर सकते हैं। मिस्टर सिंह,
मिस्टर आरके सिंह, आपके लिए जवाब बड़ा सीधा है। आप अपना फ्लैट किसी को भी बेच सकते हैं, इसमें कोई आपको रोक नहीं सकता। सोसाइटी की बड़ी पुरानी आदत है अपने मेंबर्स को बुली करना, लेकिन सोसाइटी आपको आपका फ्लैट बेचने से रोक नहीं सकती। इसका एक कारण है, सोसाइटी आपके फ्लैट की मालिक नहीं है, आपके फ्लैट का मालिक आप खुद हैं। सोसाइटी सिर्फ बिल्डिंग के जो कॉमन एरियाज हैं, ड्राइववे, बेसमेंट, गार्डन, क्लब हाउस, सोसाइटी उसकी मालिक होती है, और ये सब चीजों में आपका एक प्रोपोर्शनल शेयर है। तो जहां तक इसमें यह बात है, सोसाइटी की जो ओनरशिप है वो सिर्फ बिल्डिंग के कॉमन एरियाज में है और उस सोसाइटी में आपके शेयर्स हैं। तो इसलिए अगर आप अपना फ्लैट बेच रहे हैं किसी को, सोसाइटी बिल्कुल ऐसा नहीं कर सकती, क्योंकि सोसाइटी के पास महाराष्ट्र कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज एक्ट में ऐसी कोई अथॉरिटी नहीं है। सेकेंडली, ये डायरेक्ट आपके राइट टू प्रॉपर्टी विच इज आर्टिकल 300A ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, ये इसका उल्लंघन करता है।
right.
तो मैं आपसे कहता हूं आप बिल्कुल बेफिक्र रहिए, आप जिसको चाहें अपनी प्रॉपर्टी बेच सकते हैं, आप रजिस्ट्री करा लीजिए, और अगर सोसाइटी आपको सताना शुरू करें या ट्रबल करना शुरू करें, यू कैन इमीडिएटली मूव द कोऑपरेटिव कोर्ट अगेंस्ट हैरेसमेंट बाय द सोसाइटी अंडर सेक्शन 91 ऑफ द कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज एक्ट।
राइट, मिस्टर सिंह ये बताइए कि ये जो लेटर, जो एनओसी आपको नहीं मिल रहा है, सोसाइटी नहीं दे रही है, क्या उससे आपका कोई काम रुका हुआ है?
हाँ मैडम, अभी लोन नहीं हो रहा है, बैंक का लोन नहीं हो रहा है, सिडको में जो ट्रांसफर प्रोसेस होता है वो नहीं हो रहा है,
तो वो सब एनओसी मांग रहे सोसाइटी की।
हाँ हमने एनओसी मांगा, उन्होंने पैसे भी लिए मेरे से। यहाँ
नहीं, 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 जो सिडको में आपका काम रुका हुआ है, क्या सिडको आपसे सोसाइटी की एनओसी मांग रही है?
हाँ सोसाइटी, हाँ एनओसी मांग रही है सिडको
जी। इसमें पहली चीज ये है कि सिडको भले ही एनओसी मांगे, बैंक के अपने ही पॉलिटिक्स होते हैं। आप पहले बैंक से कहिए कि आरबीआई गाइडलाइन की जो आपका लोन रिफ्यूज कर रहे हैं उनका बड़ा सीधा उनसे बोले कि आरबीआई के गाइडलाइंस कोट करें। क्या आरबीआई गाइडलाइंस में लिखा है कि सोसाइटी के एनओसी जरूरी है? जब सोसाइटी आपके फ्लैट की मालिक नहीं है तो आप वो कैसे रोक सकती है? एंड सेकेंडली, सोसाइटी आपसे ड्यूज क्लेम कर सकती है, अगर आप ड्यूज ना दे तो सोसाइटी आप पे सिविल सूट डाले, लेकिन सोसाइटी आपका ट्रांसफर रजिस्टर करना होगा, उससे सोसाइटी बच नहीं सकती। और तीसरा, अगर बैंक आपको और सताएं, आप आरबीआई में कंप्लेंट कर सकते हैं या फिर आप बैंकिंग ओम्बड्समैन के साथ कंप्लेंट कर सकते हैं कि मुझे
बैंक सता नहीं रहे, बैंक नहीं सता रहे, सोसाइटी ही मतलब नहीं दे रही है, मतलब
नहीं, अगर बैंक आपको लोन देने से अगर इनकार कर रही है तो एक तो बैंक
में पहले सिडको ट्रांसफर नहीं हो रहा है मैडम। सिडको से जो एनओसी मिलता है ना, एक एनओसी सिडको से मिलता है, यहाँ पर हम लोगों का सिडको ट्रांसफर होती है हमारी प्रॉपर्टी, तो यहाँ पे मुझे जिसे मेरा मेंबरशिप जो रिजाइन करना पड़ता है सोसाइटी में, तो हमारा वो लेटर ही नहीं एक्सेप्ट कर रहे हैं, बोलते नहीं मैं ये लेटर लूंगा ही नहीं। जैसे मेरा रेजिग्नेशन और न्यू मेंबर का जो मेंबरशिप बनना है उसके लिए वो हमारा जो लेटर एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर रहे हैं, बोलते नहीं हम जब तक आप एनओसी
नहीं लोगे तब तक। मैटर एस्केलेट करे आदित्य, क्या करे यहाँ पर सिडको का जो ऑफिसर है, अगर वो इनकी बात नहीं मान रहा है तो मैटर एस्केलेट करे।
सबसे पहले आपका नवी मुंबई में आपका घर कहाँ पड़ता है, किस एरिया में?
कामोठी में पड़ता है, खारगर
राइट। मेरे ख्याल से खारगर ऑलरेडी अब एनएमएमसी के अंडर में मेरे ख्याल से आ चुका है।
नहीं सर, अभी सिडको के अंदर है सर।
ओके, हाँ बिल्कुल, सिडको ने शायद उसको ट्रांसफर नहीं किया एनएमएमसी को।
नहीं,
तो फिर भी, तो जहां तक सिडको का एनओसी है, सिडको देखिए, सिडको का काम है लीज देना, तो सिडको सिडको ने जब सिडको अगर सोसाइटी के एनओसी पे सिडको ने अगर मांगा, तो आपको यह देखना है कि टू व्हाट एक्सटेंट सिडको कैन नॉट रजिस्टर. आप सिडको के रेलेवेंट रूल्स देख लीजिए, इसमें जो सिडको के जो रेगुलेशंस हैं, और साथ में द नवी मुम, बिकॉज सिडको कम्स अंडर द नवी द सिडको के एक रेगुलेशंस हैं विच आर द नवी मुंबई डिस्पोजल ऑफ लैंड रेगुलेशंस. आप वो रेगुलेशंस रेफर करिए, सिडको के सारे प्रोसीजर्स, लैंड रिलेटेड सारे प्रोसीजर्स हैं, वो सिडको के लैंड डिस्पोजल रूल्स के हिसाब से होते हैं. आप एक बार वो रूल्स रेफर कर लीजिए.
राइट आदित्य, ये जो आप कह रहे हैं काफ़ी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड लग रहा है, क्या बेहतर ये होगा कि ये किसी लॉयर के पास चले जाए और सोसाइटी को एक लीगल नोटिस भेज दे? मेरे ख्याल से वो काफ़ी होगा कि सोसाइटी उन्हें एनओसी दे दे.
बिल्कुल, मैं ये कहूँगा कि आप सबसे पहले अपनी, अगर सोसाइटी पूरी बात अगर सोसाइटी एनओसी की है, आप तुरंत सेक्शन 91 के तहत ऑफ द कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज एक्ट, आप कोऑपरेटिव कोर्ट में एक कंप्लेन फाइल, एक एप्लीकेशन डाल सकते हैं, और साथ में आप एक एप्लीकेशन फॉर इंटरिम रिलीफ भी डाल दीजिए कि जब तक ये केस डिसाइड नहीं होता, क्योंकि मुझे अपनी सेल जल्द से जल्द करनी है, इंटरिम ऑर्डर्स दिए जाए टू द सोसाइटी टू ग्रांट द एनओसी.
राइट, तो एसेंशियली मिस्टर सिंह आपको यही करना है, आपको ये याद रखना है कि जो प्रॉपर्टी आपने खरीदी है उसे बेचने का आप पूरा पूरा हक रखते हैं. एंड सो व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज इंश्योर दैट यू सेंड अ लीगल नोटिस. एक लीगल नोटिस आप भेज दीजिए एक लॉयर के हाथों अपने सोसाइटी को, एंड डिमांड दैट दे हैंड ओवर एन एनओसी फॉर यू. दैट इटसेल्फ शुड गेट द सोसाइटी टू टू बेसिकली फॉल इन लाइन.
एंड जस्ट वन मोर पॉइंट, आप नवी मुंबई डिस्पोजल ऑफ लैंड रेगुलेशंस भी देख लीजिए, क्योंकि सारे सिडको के एनओसीज उसी के अंडर में आते हैं. अगर सिडको एक एनओसी डाले जो उन रेगुलेशंस में नहीं है, यू कैन डायरेक्टली चैलेंज सिस्को ऑन दिस ग्राउंड. आपको शायद कोर्ट में जाना पड़े, बट द लॉ विल बी इन योर फेवर.
राइट, जो कानून है आपके हक में है मिस्टर सिंह. एंड गोइंग ऑन टू कुमार्स क्वेश्चन, ही सेज ही इज ऑलरेडी पेड 10% एडवांस टू द बिल्डर, बट देयर इज नो एग्रीमेंट, नो डॉक्यूमेंट इन प्लेस. ही आस्क्स अस इफ ही कैन आस्क फॉर अ कंप्लीट रिफंड, or is the builder going to deduct some amount from the amount that Kumar has already given him? Now I'm assuming here, Aditya, that Kumar wants to cancel that sale for whatever reason.
Yes.
And there is a 10% amount that he's paid him. What can he do now?
Well, let me assume that the building is under construction. Now if the building is under construction, Mr. Kumar can take benefit of the Real Estate Regulation Act. Under Section 13 of the Real Estate Regulation Act, any payment of no payment of more than 10% can be made without a proper registered agreement. It clearly states that if the builder can take up to 10% payment, if he accepts 1 rupee beyond 10%, he has to register the agreement. Now, in case, let's suppose he has paid 10%, then it is Mr. Kumar's legitimate expectation under RERA that the builder should register an agreement and then take the balance payment. Now, if the builder is not registering any agreement, what to do? Now, in every state, RERA has been virtually established, or is the process of being established. We have like the provisional RERA in Maharashtra. He should immediately file a complaint under Section 31 of the RERA Act, alleging these malpractices by the builder. Once this complaint is filed, the RERA authority will issue notice under Section 35 to the builder, and this entire process will last 60 or 90 days. Within that, the builder has to file a reply, and here we have a conclusive case of malpractice, the RERA can easily impose penalties on the developer under Section 38 of the Real Estate Regulatory Act and direct him to not only refund that amount but also to pay interest. So the quickest sure-shot remedy, I would say, for him is under RERA.
So quickest sure-shot remedy is under RERA. Of course, we do not know which city he is writing in from. So
it's a national act. Also,
it is a national act, of course. So it doesn't really matter, you're saying, whether or not his particular state has actually notified these rules and whether there is an appellate authority in place?
Well, as far as the rules are concerned, the purpose of the rule is to serve the object of the act. In Mr. Kumar's case, I have cited the sections of the Real Estate Regulatory Act, which even the state governments cannot overrule. So once a project falls under Section 4, if it falls, if it's an ongoing project and it falls within the scope of RERA, nothing can stop Mr. Kumar from availing his remedy under the Act.
Right. And when you say ongoing projects, Aditya, if you could just clarify that for all our viewers, what does an ongoing project mean? Under the definition of the RERA Act, is it a building which is currently under construction where you can see work happening? Or does it also cover all those delayed projects that we've been hearing of, where people are stuck, where people have put in all their life savings?
Very good question. The answer is direct. A project which has not received the occupancy certificate is deemed to be an ongoing project.
So any project which does not have an occupancy certificate is covered by RERA. And the other important thing that you need to remember here is whether or not your state has enacted the RERA rules, has notified the RERA rules, it doesn't matter. The fact is that RERA at the end of the day is a central act, which means you can still demand protection under the RERA Act. Moving on to Satya's question. Now, Satya booked a flat in E-City Phase 1. The builder says he's not ready to negotiate. Can he cancel or go ahead? There is no sale agreement, he says. And now the builder is not ready to give my money back. What should I do? This is another case for RERA. Aditya?
Well, he is helped by two laws. I assume that he's in Maharashtra. So we have the Maharashtra Ownership Flats Act. Under Section 8 of the Maharashtra Ownership Flats Act and Section 19 of the Real Estate Regulatory Act, both of these acts state that if a builder defaults or violates his contractual obligations, that is, he does not give possession by the due date, he violates the terms of the agreement, then he has to refund the entire amount back to the buyer with interest. There can be not a single rupee of deductions if the concerned buyer is able to make out a case under Section 8 of the MOFA Act or under Section 19 of the Real Estate Regulatory Act.
Right. And of course, with that, we do come to an end of this episode of Property Hotline. We are rapidly running out of time, but we leave you with this piece of good news. If you are in Maharashtra, if you're a home buyer in Maharashtra, this is something that should make you happy. Maharashtra will get its real estate regulator on the 1st of May, that is on Maharashtra Day. That is something that all home buyers have been awaiting for a long, long time. And it is finally coming to pass. And let me also tell you this. We are very happy in telling you this, that Magicbricks Now, along with a panel of experts, we had raised a number of demands to the state government. We had in fact sent them a dossier of suggestions. And I'm happy to say that they have included these in the RERA rules. This is what we asked for. Of course, we asked that carpet area builders not be allowed to sell car parking spaces. We had asked that builders not be allowed to recalculate carpet area at the time of possession. So these are all things that we had raised, demands that we had raised, which are now part of the real estate regulatory authority that will be implemented in Maharashtra starting May 1. Thank you very much, and thank you, Aditya, for coming in and answering all those questions. And thank you for tuning in. And if you have any questions on real estate, do send them in to us.
You can watch live TV on our website, mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.